Wet your hands with water. Apply soap, rub your hands palm to palm, and wash the backs of both hands and in between your fingers. Then palm to palm with fingers interlocked. Clasp your hands together and rub. And then clean around the thumbs too. Rub your fingertips in the palms of your hands and finish off with the wrists. Rinse your hands really well with water and dry them thoroughly with a paper towel. Use the towel to turn off the tap. Your hands are now clean.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. In the name of Allah, who is the most gracious and most merciful. Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. How are you all? Hopefully, you all will be fine. First of all, I would like to say welcome you all in my online lecture of social studies subject and Saudi history for grade 2. This is week number 18 and lecture number 2. As you know, my name is Mrs. Sadaf Amreen. Okay. Before going to start, we have a look on some general instructions. So what are those instructions? First of all, mark your attendance. Dear students, first of all, you have to mark your attendance. Secondly, keep ready your book, notebook, pencil, eraser and sharpener to note down the answers of the questions. Thirdly, if you have any question, please ask questions in the WhatsApp group. Hopefully, the instructions are clear to follow. What is the topic today? The topic remains same today also because we have to continue the same lesson today also. This was the lesson number 14. The topic of the lesson is weather, and this is unit number 8, geography. So today we will learn more about of this lesson, okay, and we will do some exercises. Okay, lesson number 14, weather, unit number 8, geography. What we will do today in this lecture, or what are the things that are included in this lecture? The contents are, first of all, there is a preview. I will quickly revise the whole lesson that we have studied before, and the second thing is matching exercise that you have to do on your notebook 1 till 4. There were 4 matching words that you have to match with other 4 words. Okay, so, and after that there is a Saudi history portion also in this lecture. So we will do question number 11. Okay, so get ready for that. First of all, preview of the lesson. Lesson number 14, weather, unit number 8, geography. So I will quickly revise what we have studied in this lesson. So get ready for that. As our topic is weather, so we have studied about these words to describe the weather. For example, if we want to tell someone about the condition of the weather, then we will use these words. So what is the weather like today? So if we want to tell the answer of this question, so we have to use these words, that today the weather is sunny, today the weather is rainy, today the weather is cloudy, or today the weather is windy or snowy. So sunny, rainy, cloudy, windy, snowy are the words that describe the condition of the weather. So we use these words to describe the weather. Okay. In our lesson weather, we have studied four seasons. And what are the four seasons in a year? Spring season, summer season, autumn season, and winter season. In our Pakistan, there are four seasons in a year: spring, summer, autumn, and winter. Okay, so in spring season, you can see that there is a lot of greenery in the picture, and everything looks like very happy, like flowers bloom, trees are also green with their green leaves, grass is also green. Kids are happy, they can play outside, so there is no worry about the cold or hot weather. It is very pleasant weather, not very hot, not very cold. So this is a very beautiful time of the year. And after spring, there is a summer season. Summer is a very hottest time of the year. ठीक है, ये सबसे ज़्यादा गर्म तरीन टाइम होता है साल का, that is called summer. And during summer, you can enjoy outdoor sports like swimming, and you can also enjoy the delicious and tastiest fruit, that is mango. Okay, and after summer, when autumn come, in autumn you can see the leaves, color of the leaves are changed here, they turn into brown instead of green, and they are also fall down. So this weather is also not very hot, not very cold, but this weather is very dry. Okay, and nowadays today the month is October month is ongoing, so autumn season is ongoing. Okay, in September, October, and November are the months of autumn season. So nowadays, which season is ongoing? Autumn season. That's why we feel very dryness. Okay, because this weather is very dry. And after autumn, winter come. Winter is also a very coldest time. Winter is a very coldest time of the year. Okay, you need to take care of yourself. How you can take care of yourself? You have to wear warm woolen clothes, and you should wear cap, shoes, and gloves also, because it is the very coldest time of the year. And but you can enjoy your indoor games, and you can enjoy the dry fruits also, and you can also enjoy the snowfall also if you want to visit to the Murray in this season. Okay, so winter is also a very beautiful season, but it is very coldest time of the year. Okay, here is the poem that I have sung in previous lecture, but today I will not sing this poem again. I will just tell you about the things that are described in this poem. Here, as we have studied four seasons of the year: summer, winter, autumn, spring. So in this poem, there are some characteristics of different seasons. Like summer is very hottest weather of the year, hottest time of the year. Okay, and as you know that we can, but it is good to enjoy outside sports. For especially swimming, and we can also enjoy mangoes. And after summer, autumn comes. Autumn is a very pleasant weather, but dry weather. Leaves fall down and they change their color. And after autumn, winter comes. Winter is a very coldest time of the year, and we can enjoy outdoor we cannot enjoy outdoor activities. We have to stay at our home, and we can enjoy indoor activities or games, and we can enjoy the dry fruits also. And we have to wear very warm woolen cloths to keep us safe from the cold. And after winter, spring season starts. Okay, spring is a very pleasant weather. Everyone becomes happy. This weather is a very you can say that not very hot, not very cold. It is a very pleasant weather. Flowers bloom, trees are full of green leaves everywhere. You can see there are a lot of greenery in the spring season. Everyone becomes happy, including animals, birds, and human beings also. So this is a very beautiful time of the year. Okay, my dear students, so we have quickly revised about the seasons in our lesson number 14, weather. In our previous lecture, we have also done these two questions of exercise number C, question number 1 and 2, page number was 70, and you have to note down these questions on your notebook. I hope that you have noted down. And first of all, I want to tell you the name of the unit, unit number, and lesson number. The unit number was 8, geography. Lesson number is 14, weather. Exercise C, question 1 and 2, page number 70. So you have done, I think, inshallah, you have, I hope that you have done in your notebook these questions. I will quickly revise question number 1. What kind of clothes do you wear in summer? Answer is, we wear cotton clothes in summer. Question number 2. What kind of clothes do you wear in winter? Answer is, we wear warm woolen clothes in winter. So these are the two questions that you have done in your notebook. So what we will do next today? Okay, get ready for that. Okay, my dear students, the same lesson, unit number 8, geography, lesson number 14, weather. We have to do a exercise of matching exercise that you have to do on your notebook. Okay, there are 4 words and in one column and 4 words in another column. We have to match the words with one column to another column. Okay. So what are those words? In the first column, you can see the word is summer, then winter, then autumn, and then spring. And in the other column, you can see the word, first word is cold, hot, flowers bloom, leaves fall. So here are the characteristics of these weather. So you have to match the weather with their characteristics. Okay. So the first way is summer. Summer is cold or hot? Summer is hot. So you have to match with hot. H-O-T, hot. Okay. S-U-M-M-E-R, summer. H-O-T, hot. So you have to match summer with hot. Then the second word, winter. W-I-N-T-E-R, winter. And winter is a cold weather. So you have to match with cold. C-O-L-D, cold. Winter, cold. So you have to match winter with cold. And after winter, the third word is autumn. A-U-T-U-M-N, autumn. Autumn, flowers bloom or leaves fall? Yes, leaves fall. Okay, so you have to match with leaves fall. L-E-A-V-E-S, leaves. F-A-L-L, fall. Autumn, leaves fall. So you have to match autumn with leaves fall. Then the last word, that is spring. S-P-R-I-N-G, spring. S-P-R-I-N-G, spring. So in spring, flowers bloom. So you have to match spring with flowers. F-L-O-W-E-R-S, flowers. B-L-O-O-M, bloom. Spring, flowers bloom. Okay, we have done this matching exercise, and you have to note down this exercise on your notebook. Okay, matching 1 till 4 on copy. You have to draw the margin line, write down the CW, then topic, and then you have to write down the matching exercise. Okay, that is, you have to draw the two columns. Okay, you have to draw a margin line, or you can write like me. I have written here in two columns, and I have colored two columns differently, so you can do as I have done over here. Okay, and match. Okay, so this is your classwork and homework as well. Okay, you have to complete this exercise on your notebook, and keep remember that your writing must be very good, neat, clean. Okay, draw your margin line also. Don't forget to draw the margin line. Write down the date, CW, topic, everything. And as you are addicted to do your work in the school, similarly you are staying at home, but you have to do the, your work as you were done in your school. Okay. Okay, my dear students, what is next? Let's see. Now it's time for the Saudi history subject. Okay, so what we will learn in Saudi history? Let's see. In Saudi history, question number 11 is continue. We have done question number 1, 2, 3, 4 till 5. And today we will do, these are not questions, these are the fill in the blanks. So we have done number 1 till number 5 fill in the blanks in our previous lectures. So today is number 6 and number 7. These two fill in the blanks we will do today. Okay. So there are, number 6 is, there are 13 provinces of Saudi Arabia. There are dash provinces of Saudi Arabia, 13. What is the spelling of 13? T-H-I-R-T-E-E-N, 13. My dear students, you have to note down this on your Saudi history copy. But if you have the same copy of Saudi history and social study, so you have you have made the portion of Saudi history in your social study copies. So you have to note down in Saudi history portion of your social studies copy. Okay. So, and the same thing that you have to keep in mind, that your writing must be very much beautiful, neat and clean. Okay. So you have to follow the four lines, and automatically your writing will be good. Okay. So once again, the filling the blanks number 6, there are dash provinces of Saudi Arabia, there are 13 provinces of Saudi Arabia, T-H-I-R-T-E-E-N, 13. How many provinces of Saudi Arabia? 13. Okay, number 7 is, dash is written on Saudi flag, dash is written on Saudi flag. Shahada. Shahada is written on Saudi flag. S-H-A-H-A-D-A. Shahada. You can see here. What is Shahada? You can see this is La ilaha illallahu Muhammadur Rasulullah is called Shahada. Okay. This is the, you can see here, this is Shahada, that is written on Saudi flag. Okay. You can see this is the Saudi flag. Okay, so Shahada is written on Saudi flag. So say, what are the spellings of Shahada? S-H-A-H-A-D-A, S-H-A-H-A-D-A, Shahada. So we have done these two fill in the blanks today, number 6 and number 7. Now I will repeat again. Number 6, there are dash provinces of Saudi Arabia. There are 13 provinces of Saudi Arabia. THIRTEEN 13. Number 7 is Shahada. 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 Dash is written on Saudi flag. What is written on Saudi flag? Shahada. SHAHADA. Shahada is written on Saudi flag. Understand? You have to note down these two filling the blanks on your Saudi history portion of your social study copy. But if you have separate, you can write down on separate notebook of Saudi history. Okay? Now this is all about from my side. If you have any question, you can ask me questions in the WhatsApp group. Okay, my dear students, you can ask me any question in the WhatsApp group. Okay, thanks for watching. Thank you so much. Stay blessed always. Take care of yourself. Allah Hafiz.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, dear students. How are you all? I hope all of you good and safe at your homes. This Islamiyat lecture is presented to you by Pakistan International School, Riyadh, for the subject of Islamiyat, Grade 2, Week 18. And I am your Islamiyat teacher, Mrs. Nishat Ismat. Welcome, my dear students. Revision time. Today we will have some revision all the previous concept and all the previous fill-ups we have learned. As you all know that the exam is proceeding so far that we have to do a lots of revision. Okay? Yeah. Dear students, today we will doing a fill-ups of all these units. And as you know, we have already done of these units, but we are doing a revision in this lecture. So today we will doing a revision of unit 2 and unit 4, unit 15, sorry, unit 5, unit 6, unit 8, unit 12, and also unit 14. Okay, today we will doing a revision of these units. Okay, so first of all, unit 2, unit 2, page 11, exercise 2. Use these words to fill in the blanks. Okay, use these words to fill in the blanks: bloom, spring, ripen, loving, grow, sun, loves, and obeying. Okay, A. Allah blesses us because He dash us. Allah blesses us because He dash us. Allah blesses us because He love us. Next one, we thank Allah by dash Him, by dash to Him, and by dash Him. We can thank Allah by obeying Him, and by praying Him, and by loving Him. Okay, next one, Allah makes the animals and trees dash. Allah makes the animals and trees dash. Allah makes the animals and trees grow. Allah makes the animals and trees grow. Next one, D. Allah bring out the dash every morning. Allah brings out the dash every morning. Allah bring out the sun every morning. Okay. Next one. Allah makes the flowers dash and fruits dash. Allah makes the flowers bloom and fruits ripen. Okay. These fill in the blanks. This fill in the blanks of unit 2, page 11, exercise 2. Okay, next. Okay, next, unit 4, page 22. Unit 4, page 22, exercise 2. A. His father, Hazrat Dash, died even before Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam was born. His father Hazrat Abdullah died even before Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam was born. Next one, Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam foster mother was called dash. Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam foster mother was called Halima Sadia. Foster mother was called Halima Sadia. Yes. Next one. His mother Dash died when he was only Dash year old. His mother Dash died when he was only Dash year old. His mother Amina. His mother Amina died when he was only 6 year old. Okay, Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam only 6 year old थे जब उनकी मदर बीबी आमना इस दुनिया से रुखसत हो गई थी. Okay, next one, his grandfather was Dash and his uncle was Dash. His grandfather was Dash and his uncle was Dash. His grandfather was Abdul Muttalib and his uncle was Abu Talib. His grandfather was Abdul Muttalib and his uncle was Abu Talib. What was the name uncle of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam? Abu Talib. And grandfather name? Abdul Muttalib. Yes. And his father name Abdullah. And his mother name Bibi Amina. And his foster mother name Halima Sadia. Good. Next one and last. Our dear Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam was given the title Dash and Dash. Our dear Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam was given the titles Dash and Dash, Sadiq and Amin. Sadiq and Amin. Can you tell me what is the meaning of Sadiq and Amin? Sadiq means Sacha and Amin means Amanatdar. Okay? Yes, I hope you will understand very well. Okay, next. Yes, dear students, Unit 5, page 26. Unit 5, page 26, exercise 2. Al-Fatiha, 30. Hafiz, Al-Nas, 23. 114. Namaz and Arabic. Okay, first one, the Quran is in the Dash language. The Quran is in the Dash language. The Quran is in the Arabic language. The Quran is in the Arabic language. Next one, the Quran has Dash Surah. The Quran has Dash Surah. My dear students, can anyone tell me how many surah of the Quran? Yes, 114. 114 surah in the Quran. Okay, next one. The first surah is Dash. The first surah is Surah Fatiha. The first surah is Surah Fatiha. The last surah is Al-Nas. The last surah is Al-Nas. And next one, the Quran is divided into Dash paras. The Quran is divided into Dash paras. The Quran is divided into 30 paras. The Quran is divided into 30 paras. Next one, the Quran was completed. The Quran was completed in Dash years. The Quran was completed in 23 years. How many years? Yes, 23. Very good. The grant was completed in 23 years. Next one, we read passage from the Quran in every dash. We read passage from the Quran in every dash. We read passage from the Quran in every namaz. We read passage from the Quran in every namaz. Next one, one who memorized the Quran by heart is called. One who memorized the Quran by heart is called a dash. One who memorized the Quran by heart is called a hafiz. One who memorized the Quran by heart is called a hafiz. Okay. Dear students, these fill in the blanks are unit 5, page 26. Okay? Yes. Okay, students. Now, unit 6, page 31. Unit 6, page 31. Use these words to fill in the blanks. Pillar, praying, Khana Kaaba, Surah and Wuzu. First one, a person is close to Allah. A person is close to Allah when he is dash. A person is close to Allah when he is praying. Next one, namaz is an important dash of Islam. Namaz is an important dash of Islam. Namaz is an important pillar of Islam. Next one, we read passage or dash from the Quran in namaz. We read passage or dash from the Quran in namaz, surah. We read passage or surah from the Quran in namaz. Next one, we face the dash while praying. We face the dash while praying. We face the Khana-e Kaaba. We face the Khana-e Kaaba while praying. Next one and last, dash means to purify oneself before a namaz. Wuzu means to purify oneself before a namaz. Okay? These fill in the blanks are unit 6, page 31. Exercise 2. Okay? Next. Okay. Unit 8, page 41. Next, unit 8, page 41. Use these words to fill in the blanks. Staff, saf, member, muazzin, pray, khutbah, jamaat and sajda. First one, a mosque is a place where Muslim dash. A mosque is a place where Muslim pray. Next one, in Arabic, masjid mean a place to do dash. In Arabic, masjid means a place to do sajda. Next one, a dash is a person who calls out the azan. A muazzin is a person who calls out the azan. And next one, a dash is a sermon. A khutbah is a sermon. And next one, khutbah is given from the dash. Khutbah is given from the member. Next one, the row of namaz is called a dash. The row of namaz is called a saf. S-A-double-F, saf. Next one and last, a group of namazi is called a dash. A group of namazi is called a dash. A group of namazi is called a jamaat. Okay? These fill in the blanks are Unit 8, page 41, exercise 2. Okay? Next. Okay. Next, Unit 12, page 55. Unit 12, page 55, exercise 3. Use these words to fill in the blanks: friends, scream, parents, feed, and help. First one, you should be kind to your dash. You should be kind to your parents. You should be kind to your parents and listen to them and dash them. And listen to them and help them if they need you. Okay? Next one, you should be kind. You should be dash to your pet. You should be dash to your pet animals and dash it on time. You should be kind to your pet animals and feed on time. Okay? You should be kind to your pet animals and feed on time. It on time. Next one. See, we must not dash at servants or dash them. We must not scream at servants or insult them. Okay? Next one and last, if you are kind, you can make dash easily. If you are kind, you can make dash easily. If you are kind, you can make friend easily. Okay? If you are kind, you can make friend. If you are kind, you can make friends easily. Once again, if you are kind, you can make friends easily. Okay, dear students, these fill in the blanks of Unit 12, page 55, exercise 3. Okay, yes, next. Yes, Unit 14 and Unit last of this semester. Okay, Unit 14 and Unit last of first semester. Page 62. Exercise 2. Use these words to fill in the blanks also. Young, cheats, fights, time, elders, and bell. First one, a good Muslim never dash over small things. A good Muslim never dash over small things. A good Muslim never fight. A good Muslim never fights over small things. Okay. Next one. A good Muslim respects dash and cares for the dash. A good Muslim respects elders and cares for the young. Okay. Next one. A good Muslim never uses dash words. A good Muslim never uses bad words. Next one. A good Muslim never lies or dash. A good Muslim never lies or cheats. Yani achhe Musliman jhoot nahi bolte. Achhe Musliman dhokha nahi dete. Okay. Next one and last. A good Muslim never wastes dash in useless things. A good Muslim never wastes dash in useless things. A good Muslim never wastes time in useless things. Okay? A good Muslim never wastes time in useless things. A good Muslim never wastes time in useless things. यानी अच्छे मुसलमान अपना टाइम अपना वक्त बेकार में ज़ाया नहीं करते। जैसे कि आजकल आपके एग्ज़ाम आने वाले हैं, तो आपने अपना टाइम ज़ाया नहीं करना, अच्छे तरीके से अपने एग्ज़ाम की तैयारी करनी है। ओके, बिकॉज यू आर गुड स्टूडेंट्स एंड आई नो यू आर वेरी गुड स्टूडेंट्स। ओके, यस, गुड। ओके डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अपकमिंग लेक्चर, एंड इन आवर अपकमिंग लेक्चर व्हाट विल बी डूइंग, अपकमिंग लेक्चर व्हाट विल बी डूइंग, वी विल बी डूइंग ऑल शॉर्ट क्वेश्चंस एंड ऑल डिटेल क्वेश्चन। ओके, बिकॉज वी विल रिवाइज एवरीथिंग। ओके ओके माई डियर स्टूडेंट, थैंक यू फॉर लिसनिंग टू मी इन दिस लेक्चर। इंशाल्लाह वी विल सी यू इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन, इफ यू हैव एनी क्यूरीज, इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट, यू कैन आस्क योर इस्लामिया टीचर थ्रू व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप। ओके, विश यू सक्सेस इन योर एग्जाम, गॉड विल श्योरली ब्लेस यू all with good result, lots of good wishes. Okay, God bless you. Allah Hafiz.
Assalamu alaikum and good evening everyone. How are you dear students? Hope all of you are fit, fine and happy at your homes. Dear students, I am your computer science teacher and I welcome you all in part 2 of lecture number 13. So get ready for your computer class. Today we are going to revise the names from chapter number 1, that was Windows Paint Drawing Tools, and chapter number 1 was about Windows Paint Editing Tools. So get ready for it, as today we are going to revise the names of drawing tools and the names of editing tools. These two things we have to revise today. So get ready for it, as you know that we studied two groups. These are the names, these are the groups of Windows Paint Drawing Tools. We studied these groups in chapter number 1, and Windows Paint Drawing Tools. These are the Windows Paint Drawing Tools, and then in chapter number 2 we studied about Windows Paint Editing Tools. These two groups, Clipboard and Image Group, these are the names of two editing groups. So let's start. First of all, we will revise the names and the icons of the editing tools. So here are the editing tools, clipboard and the image. It looks like this. Clipboard and image, these two are the groups, and first one is the clipboard and the second is image. We will revise one by one. We will start with clipboard. In clipboard group, that is the group name of the group. What's the name of this group? Clipboard. So the name of this group is clipboard. And here are three icons. As you can see, the first one is paste. First icon look like this. It looks like clipboard, right? The clipboard you use during exams while doing your papers. It looks like this. So paste, then on number 2, cut. That is the icon for cut. It is a scissor. It looks like a scissor. And on number 3 is copy. There are two pages with something written in it. Like you can see, there are lines in the pages, two pages, and it is the icon for copy. So in clipboard group, how many buttons are there? Three buttons. First one, paste, then cut, and third one is copy. These are the names of editing tools in the clipboard group. Now, moving on to the image group. In the image group, there are four buttons with the different icons. This is the image group. As you can see, in image group, there are four different icons with the different names and the buttons. The first one is the select, and its icon is like a dotted square. As you can see, dotted square, and this icon is for select button. Now the second button on the image group is crop. The icon for crop looks like this. It's the icon for crop. In order to crop your pictures, you will click on this button. And then on number 3, resize. Resize button is also on the image group. And the last one, number fourth, is rotate. So how many buttons are on the image group? In the image group, there are four buttons. Select, crop, resize, and rotate. These are the buttons that are on the image group. So moving on to the next one, next slide. So we are going to now learn about the names of the drawing tools. We already covered the names in our previous lectures in chapter number one, right? So the first one is the tools, and the first group in the drawing tools, that is after the image group, is tools. Tools, there are how many buttons or the icons in the tool group? There are six icons or the buttons. Number one is the pencil, and then color bucket or fill with. Then A is for text. If you want to add text in your slides, then you will click on A. Number fourth is eraser. Eraser and color picker. When you click on the color picker, your mouse changes into eyedropper. It looks like this. And magnifier. How many tools are there in this group? How many buttons are there in the tools group? Number one, pencil, fill with or color bucket. And number three, text. Number four, eraser. Number five, color picker. And lastly, magnifier. Magnifier. These are the names of tools group and icons. Look like this. For pencil, you can see pencil, color bucket. It looks like color bucket. And for text, A is written, and eraser is also like erasers, and color picker is like eyedropper, and magnifier is the name of the last tool button. Okay, now moving on to the next one, that is brushes. So in the brushes, you can find so many different brushes, and we specifically studied about the airbrush. When you click on airbrush, what happened? Your mouse pointer changes into a spray can, as you can see right now. When you click on the airbrush button, your mouse pointer changes into a spray can. Now, moving on to the next one. Shapes group. We studied about shapes group, curve shape. When you click on the curve shape, what happens? Yes, your mouse pointer changes into a dotted plus sign. This happens when you click on the shapes group. So in the shapes group, there are so many different shapes. There is a straight line, curve, oval shape, square, rounded square, and then cloud call out, six pointed stars, five pointed stars, so many shapes over here in the shapes group. So in the shapes group, you can find different shapes. And when you click on the curve line, what happens? Very good. Yes, the mouse pointer changes into a dotted plus sign. Now, after the shapes, we also studied about outline. If you want to change the outline of any shape, where you will click? You will click on the drop down arrow, that is on the outline button, as you can see over here where the I'm moving my pointer, so it will be visible for you. So there are so many different outlines, like buttons, like solid color, crayon, oil, felt tip, natural pencil, watercolor. Different outlines can be drawn with the help of You can change the outline of different shapes by using this button. And after that, there is a size button, as you can see, size button. When you click on the size drop down arrow, then you can increase the size of different tools. Like you can increase the size of the pencil, make it big thicker. You can increase the size of your brush and also decrease it, make it thin or make it thicker with the help of this size. And the icon for the size button is like this. There are parallel lines, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 parallel lines. First one is thin, then it becomes thicker, thicker, and the last one is the most thickest one. So these are the on the size. This is for size icon. It looks like this. So boys and girls, thank you for listening. Today we studied or revised the names of different tools on MS Paint. Now, if you have any question, you can ask in WhatsApp group, and take care of yourselves. Good luck for your exams. Allah Hafiz.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
हाँ जी बच्चों, क्या हाल चाल है? आप लोग सब कैसे हैं? मैं आपकी कुरान टीचर मिसेज मकसूदा हूँ। आप लोगों को बेटा जो भी कुरान का सबक पढ़ाया जाता है उसको आप अच्छे तरीके से याद किया करें, और हर रोज आप स्कूल स्टार्ट होने से पहले, क्लासेस स्टार्ट होने से पहले आप पहले कुरान पढ़ लिया करें, ताकि बाकी सारे सब्जेक्ट के लिए भी अल्लाह ताला आपके जहन को खोल दे, सीनों को खोल दे, ताकि बाकी सारे सब्जेक्ट भी आप लोगों को बहुत इजी लगे। ठीक है ना बच्चों? इसी तरह करेंगे ना, सबसे पहले कुरान पढ़ें, फिर उसके बाद अपने दूसरे सब्जेक्ट शुरू कर लें। ठीक है, चलें अब हम पढ़ते हैं अपना सबक। जी बच्चों, आज हमने अपने इस लेक्चर में तीन पेज जो हैं वो पढ़ने हैं। ठीक है, आपने पहले पढ़े हुए हैं लेकिन आज हम तीनों पेज इकट्ठे पढ़ेंगे, पेज नंबर 16, पेज नंबर 18 और पेज नंबर 20। ठीक है, और हिफ्स में हम इंशाल्लाह पढ़ेंगे सूरतुल काफिरून और सूरतुन नस्र, ये भी दोनों आपने पहले पढ़ी हुई हैं, तो आज मैं दोबारा से आपको ये सूरतुल काफिरून और सूरतुन नस्र भी पढ़ाऊंगी, और नाजरा कुरानी कायदा के ये तीन पेज हम पढ़ेंगे, पेज नंबर 16, पेज नंबर 18 और पेज नंबर 20। ठीक है जी, ये है पेज नंबर 16। ठीक है, पेज नंबर 16 और ये है जेर की मशक। ठीक है, तो इसको हम रिपीट करेंगे इंशाल्लाह, पहले भी हम पढ़ चुके हैं, तो चलें इसको पढ़ना शुरू करते हैं। इसको हमने पढ़ना है बा जेर बी, दाल जबर दा, बी दा, मीम दो जेर मिन, बी दा मिन, बा जेर बी, कौफ जबर को, बी क़ा, बा जबर बा, बी क़ाबा, सीन दो ज़ेर सीन, बी क़ाबा सीन, काफ जबर का, गाल ज़ेर दी, काज़ी, बा दो ज़ेर बिन, काज़ी बिन, नून जबर ना, फा जबर फा, नाफा, क़ाफ जबर क़ा, नाफा क़ा, ता दो ज़ेर तिन, नाफा क़ा तिन, काफ जबर का, बा जबर बा, कैबा, दाल दो ज़ेर दिन, कैबा दिन। ठीक है, इसी तरह से हमने पहले भी पढ़ा ना कई दफा, तो इस तरह अब आप इस तरह पढ़ेंगे, आलाकिन, लबनिन, रकबतिन, खबरिन, अमदिन, ऐनबिन, बियादिन, अजलिन। ठीक है बच्चों, पढ़ना आता है ना? शाबाश, इसी तरह बस पढ़ते चले जाएंगे क्योंकि हम रिपीट कर रहे हैं। सामानिन, मसादिन, लहाबिन, सखातिन, अमालिन, गदाबिन, हसनिन, हा ठीक है, हसनिन, फियातिन, सफारातिन, बशारिन, मसालिन, कदरिन, साआतिन, लिगादिन, शजारिन, जकारिन, मलाकिन। ठीक है बच्चों, आपने इसी तरह से इसको पढ़ना है। ठीक है, और आपको पढ़ना भी आता है माशाल्लाह, आपने पहले भी पढ़ा हुआ है, आज तो हम रिपीट कर रहे थे। ठीक है ना, इसी तरह बस आप पढ़ लें अच्छे तरीके से। ठीक है बच्चों। हाँ जी बच्चों, ये आपके सामने पेज नंबर 18 खुल चुका है, तो पेज नंबर 18 भी हमने पहले पढ़ा हुआ है, आज रिपीट कर रहे हैं, तो चलें अब हम इसको पढ़ेंगे इस तरह से, या जबर या, हा जबर हा, या हा बा पेश बू, या हा बू, आपको पता चल गया ना पेश की मशक है। ठीक है, या हा बू, स्वाद पेश सू, है पेश हू, सूहु, फाजेर फी, सूहू फी, है पेश हू, बा पेश बू, क्या बना बच्चों? आप लोग बोले शाबाश, हुबू, काफ ज़ेर की, क्या बना? हुबू की, यस, और आपेश रू, बापेश बू, रूबू, आइन पेश ऊ, तीनों हरफों को मिलाएंगे तो बनेगा रूबू ऊ, रापेश रू, सीन पेश सू, क्या बना? रूसु, लामपेशलू, रूसुलू, इसी तरह अब हम बाकी का पढ़ेंगे। ताजीरू, ता जबर फिर जेर, ताजीरू, ठीक है, ताजीरू। आईजू, आप समझें कि इसमें जबर जेर पेश तीनों की मशक है, ठीक है। आईजू, खाबू सा, ठीक है, खाबू सा नहीं पढ़ना, खाबू सा। मुनिया, ठीक है, मुनिया नहीं पढ़ना, मुनिया, ठीक है, आइन की आवाज निकलेगी। वुजीदा, लुईना, हासुना, ठीक है, कुतीला, फुईला, उफुकी, की कॉफ मोटा है बेटा, जबान की जड़ से ये अदा होगा। उफू, उफू हो गया, दोनों पे पेश है उफू, फिर कॉफ जेर की, उफुकी, सुकीतो, ذكيرا، دعيا، نفيخا، خا، نفيخا، كلمات، كلمات كلمة، ठीक है, तू, كلمات، أخر، قرئ، آ، ये आइन नहीं है बेटा, ये हमजा है। قرئ، سئل، सुइला, वहुआ, हुशीरा, हुशीरा, नुदूरी, नुदूरी, याईदु, याईदु, कुतीबा, कुतीबा, कुदिया, कुदिया, ठीक है। काफ पेश कु, ज़ाद ज़ेर ज़ी, कुज़ी या ज़बरिया, कुज़िया, काफ पेश कु, दाल ज़ेर दी, कुदी, रा ज़बर रा, कुदी रा, कुदी रा, कुदी रा, ठीक है, कुदी रा, इसी तरह से इसको भी पढ़ना है आपने, ठीक है बेटा। जी बच्चों, आपके सामने पेज नंबर 20 खुल चुका है और पेज नंबर 20 में अब हम पढ़ेंगे दो पेश की मशक। पहले हमने पढ़ा दो पेश का सबक, अब हम सबक के बाद दो पेश की एक्सरसाइज करेंगे, ठीक है, उसकी मशक करेंगे, उसकी प्रैक्टिस करेंगे, ठीक है। चलें अब हम पढ़ना शुरू करते हैं। हमने इसको इस तरह पढ़ना है, बा जबर बा, कौफ जबर कौ, फिर दोनों हरफों को मिलाएंगे बनेगा बा कौ, रा जबर रा, बा का रा, ता दो पेशतुन, बाकारातुन, 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 हमजा जबर आ, हा जबर हा, आहा, दाल दो पेशतुन, तीनों हरफों को मिलाएंगे बनेगा आहादुन, 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 सीन पेशु, रा पेशरू, सूरु, रादो पेशरुन, सुरुरुन, सुरुरुन, ठीक है, सुरुरुन, काफ ज़ेरकी, तो जबर तो, की तो, आइन दो पेशुन, तीनों हरफों को मिलाएंगे बनेगा की तो उन, की तो उन, हा पेशु, मीम पेशमु, حومو رادو بشرون حمورون حمورون خابشخو شين بشو دونو حرفوں کو ملائیں گے خوشو بادو بشبون اب تینوں حرفوں کو ملائیں گے بنے گا خوشوبون خوشوبون عین زبر ا میم زبر ما عاما لام دو بشلون عمالون عمالون غين زبر غا با زبر با دونوں کو ملائیں گے بنے گا غابا را زبر را غابارا تا دو پشتن غاباراتن غاباراتن قاف پشکو تا پشتو کوتو با دو پشبن कुतुबुन कुतुबुन ज़ा पेश दू, लाम जबरला, जूला, लाम दो पेश लून, तीनों हरफों को मिलाएंगे बनेगा जूला लून, जूला लून, जा जबर जा, बा जबर बा, जाबा, दाल दो पेश दुन, जाबा दुन, जाबा दुन, क़ाफ जबर क़ा, दाल जबर दा, क़ादा, क़ाफ और दाल को मिलाएंगे बनेगा क़ादा, मीम दो पेश मुन, क़ादा मुन, क़ादा मुन। ठीक है बच्चों, आपको समझ आ रही है? आपने बेटा साथ साथ पढ़ना है, ठीक है? क़ादामुन हरूफ की अदायगी सही करनी है, ठीक है? क़ादामुन, क़ाफ को मोटा पढ़ना है, क़ादामुन। ख़ा पेश खू, लाम पेश लू, दोनों हरफों को मिलाएंगे क्या बनेगा? खुलू। क़ाफ दो पेश कुन, खुलू कुन, खुलू कुन। हा जबर हा, सीन जबर सा, हासा। नून जबर ना, तीनों हरफों को मिलाएंगे बनेगा हसना। ता दो पेश तुन, अब मुकम्मल लफ्ज क्या बनेगा? हसना तुन, ठीक है? हसना तुन। क़ाफ जबर क़, ता जबर ता, क़ाता। रा जबर रा, क़ाता रा। ता दो पेश तुन, मुकम्मल लफ्ज क्या बना? क़ातारातुन, क़ातारातुन। ज़ा ज़बर ज़ा, मीम ज़बर मा, ज़ामा, हमज़ा दो पेश उन, ज़ामा उन, ज़ामा उन। नून ज़बर ना, स्वाद ज़बर स्वा, दोनों हरफों को मिलाया क्या बना? नास्वा। बा दो पेश बुन, तीनों हरफों को मिलाएंगे लफ्ज़ मुकम्मल क्या बना? नास्वा बुन, नास्वाबुन। काफ जबर का, लाम जेरली, काली। मीम जबर मा, कालीमा। ता दो पिश्तुन, कालीमा तुन, कालीमा तुन। मीम जबर मा, लाम जबर ला, माला, माला। काफ दो पिश कुन, माला कुन, माला कुन। मीम जबर मा, रा जबर रा, मारा। ज़ा दो पेश ज़ुन, मारा ज़ुन, मारा ज़ुन। बा जबर बा, शीन जबर शा, दोनों हरफों को मिलाया बना बादशाह। रा दो पेश रुन, मुकम्मल लफ्ज़ क्या बनेगा? बादशाह रुन, बादशाह रुन। क़ाफ़ जबर क़ा, सीन जबर सा, क़ासा। मीम दो पेश मुन, क़ासामुन, क़ासामुन। रा ज़बर रा, जीम पेश जू, राजू, राजू। लाम दो पेश लुन, राजूलुन, राजूलुन। हा ज़बर हा, रा ज़बर रा, हारा। जीम दो पेश जुन, हारा जुन, हारा जुन। दाल जेर दी, या जबर या, दिया। ता दो पेश तुन, दिया तुन, दिया तुन। हमजा जबर आ, शीन जेर शी, आशी। रुआ दो पेश रुन, आशी रुन, आशी रुन। हमजा पेश ऊ, जाल पेश जू, उजू। नून दो पेश नून, उजू नून, क्या बना? उजू नून। लाम जबर ला, आइन जेर आई, लाई। बा दो पेश बुन, लाई बुन, लाई बुन। रो पेश रू, सीन पेश सू, दोनों हरफों को मिलाएंगे क्या बनेगा? रूसू। लाम दो पेश लुन, तीनों हरफों को मिलाएंगे क्या बनेगा? रुसूलुन, रुसूलुन। जीम पेश जू, दाल जबर दा, जूदा। दाल दो पेश दुन, जूदा दुन, जूदा दुन। अच्छा जी बच्चों, ठीक है। अब मैं आपको एक और बात बताना चाह रही हूँ, वो ये कि कि जैसे है बाकारातुन, अगर हमने इस पे रुकना होगा, वक्फ करना होगा, तो हम इसको कैसे पढ़ना है ये मैं अब आपको बताऊंगी। बाकारातुन है तो अगर हमने रुकना है तो हम पढ़ेंगे बाकारा, ठीक है, बाकारा। आहादुन है तो इस पे अगर रुकना है, वक्फ करना है, तो बोलेंगे आहद, आहद, ठीक है। सुरुरुन पे रुकना है तो सुरुर, सुरुर। की तो उन पे रुकना है तो रुकना है की तो, ठीक है। हुमुरुन पे रुकना है तो हुमुर, हुमुर। खुशुबुन पे अगर रुकना है तो खुशुब, खुशुब, ठीक है बच्चों, समझ आ गई है। ये इस तरह से जब भी किसी लफ्ज पर वक्फ करते हैं तो उसकी जो आखिर की हरकत होती है, आखिर वाले, ठीक है, वो चाहे दो जेर हैं, एक जेर है, दो पेश है, एक पेश है, जबर है, तो वो आखिर की हरकत खत्म हो जाती है। हाँ, अगर दो जबर हूं तो फिर एक जबर और अलिफ पढ़ा जाता है, ठीक है। जबादुन है तो जबद, कदमुन है तो कदम, कालीमतुन पे रुकना है तो कालीमह, ताब जो है वो हा में बदल जाएगी और हरकत भी खत्म हो जाएगी, कालीमह। और इसी तरह से हसनतुन है तो हसनह, ठीक है, इस तरह कतारतुन है तो कतारह, ठीक है, इस तरह कसमुन है तो कसम, ठीक है। और इसी तरह से जैसे मालकुन है तो मालक, ठीक है, कदमुन है तो कदम, ठीक है बच्चों। ये इस तरह से आखिर की हरकत को खत्म कर देंगे अगर वक्फ करना होगा तो, ठीक है बच्चों, समझ आ गई अच्छे तरीके से। जी बच्चों, अब हम इंशाल्लाह सूरतुन नस्र हिफ्स करेंगे। आपने हिफ्स पहले की हुई है, आज फिर हम पढ़ेंगे, याद करेंगे, ठीक है, मैं आपको हिफ्स करवाऊंगी। اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم سورة النصر مدنية بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحُ إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحُ وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَهَا بُغُنَّا كَرَنْجَ ٹھیک ہے وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَدْخُلُونَ وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا فَسَبِّحْ بحمد ربك واستغفره واستغفره ہے لیکن رکنے کے لیے واستغفره فسبح بحمد ربك واستغفره انه كان توابا انه نون کے اوپر غنہ کریں گے شاد ہے इन्नहु उल्टा पेश है तो हु इन्नहु काना तव्वाबा, ठीक है बच्चों, इसी तरह से आपने इसको याद करना है। एक दफा सुन लें फिर। बिस्मिल्लाहिर रहमानिर रहीम इदा जाअ नसरुल्लाहि वल फतह ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواجا فسبح بحمد ربك واستغفره إنه كان توابا। जी बच्चों, अब है सूरतुल काफिरून, अब हम पढ़ेंगे सूरतुल काफिरून, ठीक है। بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل يا أيها الكافرون. قل يا مد کو کھینچیں گے پھر أيها الكافرون. قل يا أيها الكافرون. لا لام کے اوپر دیکھیں یہ آپ کو نظر آ رہا ہے الف کے اوپر مد ہے تو اس کو لمبا کریں گے. لا اعبد ما تعبدون. لا اعبد عین کو گلے سے نکالیں گے تعبدون. لا اعبد ما تعبدون ولا انتم عابدون ما اعبد ولا اسی طرح ما دیئے انتم عابدون ما اعبد ٹھیک ہے ولا انتم عابدون ما اعبد ولا انا عابد ما عبدتم. پھر پڑھیں ولا انتم عابدون ما اعبد لكم دينكم ولي دين. لكم دينكم ولي دين. ایک دفعہ پھر سن لیں. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل يا أيها الكافرون لا أعبد ما تعبدون ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد ولا أنا عابد ما عبدتم ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد لكم دينكم ولي دين. ٹھیک ہے بچوں اسی طرح سے آپ نے اچھے طریقے سے یاد کرنا ہے پھر اس کو نماز میں ان دونوں صورتوں کو آپ نے نماز میں ریپیٹ کرنا ہے ٹھیک ہے شاباش. اب یہ آپ کا ہوم ورک ہے آپ نے ناظرہ میں پیج نمبر 16 18 اور 20 آپ نے پڑھنا ہے قاعدے سے دیکھ کر ٹھیک ہے اور سورۃ الکافرون اور سورۃ النصر کو آپ نے اچھے طریقے سے زبانی یاد کرنا ہے اور پھر اپنی نمازوں میں بھی آپ نے ان کو پڑھتے رہنا ہے تاکہ آپ کو بھولے نہ آپ کو یاد رہیں ٹھیک ہے بیٹا. ٹھیک ہے بیٹا اللہ حافظ. تھینک یو ویری مچ. ہمیشہ آپ لوگ خوش رہیں اور دعاؤں میں یاد رکھیں. اللہ حافظ. فی امان اللہ. السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ.